Last time we saw the corner cube reflection, but why does the ray come back to its origin's direction? I would like to explain that, and for that I need some preparation. Here there are two line segments, AB and CD. I put them together. I put a point E at the center of the line segment. We can rotate the segment CD around the point E. Then, the measures of the angle DB and AC are always the same. Can you see the measures of them are the same? They are called vertical angles. The angle AD and CB are also vertical angles, and the measures of them are the same. Why are the vertical angles the same? Some of you might say it's obvious, I can see that, but I would like to give you a proof. Because I found it nice. In the same way as before, we have a line segment AB and a point E at the center of AB. The measure of the angle AB is 180 degrees. Now we put back the line segment CD. Here is the angle DB. Because the measure of the angle AB was 180 degrees, the measure of the angle AD is 180 minus the measure of the angle DB. Let's copy this figure. For the left side, notice the segment CD. The measure of the angle CED is 180 degrees since the CD is a line segment. Let's put back the segment AB again. The measure of the angle AD is 180 minus measure of the angle AC. Since the measure of the angle CED is 180 degrees. By the way, these two figures are the identical copies. Then, both of the measures of the angle AD are the same. So I put them here. Now let's substitute the same things and subtract 180 from both sides, then multiply minus 1 to both sides. When we do that, the equality still holds. Then the measure of the angle AC is equal to the measure of the angle DB. This is a proof. It's nice, isn't it? Following the same discussion, the measure of the angle AD is equal to the measure of the angle CD. They are also called vertical angles. Okay, but we need one more preparation step. With the same setup as the last one, there's a line segment AB. Another line segment CD crosses the segment AB through the point E. Let's say this angle is alpha. Now I'll copy the segment AB, I make it A'B'. I move A'B' away from AB, but keep them in parallel. Here's a measure of the angle alpha and alpha dash are equal. These angles are called corresponding angles. This is only true when AB and A'B' are parallel. The line CD is called transversal. So far we saw a lot of angles. Corresponding angles have the same measure when the lines are parallel. Being parallel is the key here. If the lines are not parallel, corresponding angles have different measures. We have also seen vertical angles. We can of course use both. Let's combine them. Here are corresponding angles, and these are vertical angles. A vertical angle of corresponding angles have also the same measures. Therefore, alpha and beta are the same, and alpha dash and beta dash are the same too. Please note that alpha and beta dash here, they are the same too. This is called alternate interior angles. I set here interior because these are alternate exterior angles. They also have the same measures. By the way, some languages have only a term alternate interior angles and do not have a term for alternate exterior angles. Even in those languages, I can say alpha dash and beta are equal measure, but there's no explicit name. So a name is useful, but it is better if you can explain what it is even without using the name. Okay, let's label the rest of the angles. Here is delta, the corresponding angle of delta dash. The vertical angle of delta is gamma, and this is gamma dash. Delta, delta dash, gamma, and gamma dash all have equal measures. Then, delta and gamma dash are alternate interior angles, and gamma and delta dash are alternate exterior angles. I would like to make one note. If corresponding angles have the same measure, the lines must be parallel. I think it's not intuitive that parallel lines which corresponding angles don't have the same measure. Actually, from these properties, I can make one nice proof which I really like. That is a proof of angles in a triangle sum to 180 degrees. I think it's neat, so I would like to make another video in the future about that. So far, you might think how those corresponding angles and the vertical angles are connected to the corner cube reflection, but we are close to seeing it. Next time, we connect these and mirror reflection and see how a corner cube reflector works. See you in the next video.